Phone case business check.
Show all of your cases. Your newest case. The case you're most known for. Your best-selling case. Your most sparkly case. A case that took you the longest time to make. Your favorite case. Your second favorite case. The case that's on your phone right now. A case that's underrated. And any other cases you forgot to mention.
I want to know why on the new TikTok update, when you click to share a video and you click others, it asks you why. Like, mind your own business, TikTok. I want to know why on the new TikTok update, when you click to share a video and you click others, it asks you why. Like, mind your own business.
Y'all, somebody please tell me how on earth all of these small business owners are getting hundreds and hundreds of orders overnight. Please tell me. I have 8 followers.
Me arriesgué. Invertí poco de mi dinero para empezar mi propio negocio. Al principio, no veía las ganancias. Me estaba desanimando. Hasta hoy. Gracias, Dios mío.
I have my own business check. This is my most popular product. This is my favorite product. This is one of my most expensive products. This is my most affordable product.
So I decided to launch my first business, and it started off really slow. I had a few people on the website, and finally after a while, I got one order, and I was really happy. Then, all of a sudden, orders started coming in like crazy. I ended up selling out of a few items. I never thought I would be able to get this many orders on my first day, so if I can do it, you can too.
Hey guys, welcome to day 5 of starting an Etsy shop because we're bored during quarantine. So today we worked on stocking up our inventory. We started with the white gloss sticker paper and printed out our ocean pack and our space pack through the print and cut feature on Cricut Design Space. We opened up our Cricut and set up the blade pressure in the settings to the more option. We also calibrated our blade to ensure accurate cuts. We used our light grip mat and prepared our sticker sheet for cutting. The Cricut first scanned the sheet to understand where the sticker borders are, and then it started cutting. We increased the blade pressure to make sure the blade would cut all the way through the entire piece of paper. It actually looked super cool and had very accurate cuts. We then peeled the excess sticker sheet off the mat and then took each sticker off one by one. The tools were pretty helpful, but not necessary for this. We used pieces of cardstock to make sure the stickers don't bend and put all of the stickers into our little plastic baggies. To seal our bags, we covered the end of the bag with aluminum to prevent the plastic from melting and used a hair straightener to heat seal the bags. We then set up the stickers for pictures. Stay tuned for tomorrow.
Phone case business check.
Show all of your cases. Your newest case. The case you're most known for. Your best-selling case. Your most sparkly case. A case that took you the longest time to make. Your favorite case. Your second favorite case. The case that's on your phone right now. A case that's underrated. And any other cases you forgot to mention.
Hey guys, it's Aurora from West Main. Let's pack an order. So she ordered our black denim mini and a seamless tank. So after I fold the items, I move on to tissue paper.
When I worked retail, they always had us pleat it like this. I love that the folds help add a lot of dimension to the solid paper. Next, you'll see me add a sticker to the packaging. I was wondering if I should change these stickers to either white or gold. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. So with smaller items, I like to tuck in the side so it doesn't move too much in the shipping process. Next, I add my thank you cards and sticker. Then I fill my goodie bag. Finally, I can weigh the items and buy a shipping label. And that's it. She's ready to go.
I have my own business check. This is my most popular product. This is my favorite product. This is one of my most expensive products. This is my most affordable product. Yes, I know, they're just fleece. This is also one of my favorite products. These are my newest products. Also a new product.
Hi guys, today we're making lip gloss. These are gonna be two new shades. Okay, so here we're gonna start with our bowl. This is the company of Versagel that we're using, No Problema. You can find them on Etsy or there. We're gonna put half of this in.
Bit.
I've done this a lot, so I usually just eye it. This is coconut oil. Then you're gonna mix this. Now I'm going to add some vitamin E, and that just helps with moisture to your lips. Okay, now that that's mixed around, I usually check the consistency by doing this, and that's about how I like it. Here's the mica we're going to add. So it's kind of hard to show the mixing process, but this is the color. It's like a gold. Okay, we're going to go ahead and go to part two. No! I do my own nails check.
Hey guys, it's Natalie from Darling Authority, and today I'm going to show you how to ship my online order. So first I take a look at the order, go over to my clothing rack, and pick out all the items that they bought. This girl bought a really cute cardigan as well as a bralette, so this is my belts, bralettes, and jogger section. I pick out the bralette she ordered, which is a really gorgeous blue color with this crisscross backing. I then move over to my shipping station and pick out all the materials that I need. So I typically use postcards, stickers, and I also like to throw in some free scrunchies and some candy as well. I then grab my tissue paper, and I like to make this little center fold and then put all of my clothing in the middle of it. So after I do that, I fold up the sides, and finally, I put all of it together by using a sticker. Now, I created this fun little pocket to put my postcards inside, and then it's ready to go into a poly mailer, which I get on Amazon. So in order to ship my items, I use a Dymo Label Writer 4XL. It makes a really cute sticker, which is easy. I put that on the packaging, throw it with the rest of my orders, and we're done.
These are ring balms. They are $17.95. Inside is a ring valued anywhere from $25 up to $1,000. This one was $224. They're like bath bombs, but no essential oils or fragrances, so you can't put them in your bath water.
Hey guys, today I'm working on a pretty big custom order for my tie-dye Etsy shop, Cloudy Dyes. This order is 8 matching pink tie-dye sets for a customer's birthday party vacation trip. I decided to go with a two-tone pink design for an extra pop of color and dimension. For something special I decided to do for this order was to create personalized name stickers for each person in the order. This is a great way that I can give back, give them something personalized and special, and also indicate whose set belongs to who. I use my iPad Pro and my Cricut machine to die cut these stickers. This part is so satisfying and very difficult to film with one hand. As I pack the order, I lint roll every single piece and fold it very nicely so that it is absolutely perfect before it gets into my customers' hands. I package each set individually with a thank you card as well as those name stickers that we just created. If you guys want to check out my Etsy shop, you can go to cloudydyes.etsy.com. I package all 8 sets nice and snug in a box with a handwritten thank you note, and this order is ready to go.
Let's take a look at some products in my shop right now.
First off, we have banana milk, which is a thick and glossy slime scented exactly like bananas. It's been my bestseller in my shop for about a year now, and it's so thick and glossy and pokeable, and I love it so much. Next up, we have cotton candy Mallows, which has been in my shop for about 3 years now. It is so good, and it's so thick and glossy, and it smells just like cotton candy. I love the bead color combination, too. Next up, we have blue cupcake icing. Just like cotton candy Mallows, this has been in my shop for about 3 years now. It smells just like cupcakes, and it's also a customer favorite.